गुड आफ्टरनून चिल्ड्रेन.
गुड आफ्टरनून मैम.
गुड आफ्टरनून मैम.
We were discussing about the transportation of gases, how carbon dioxide and oxygen get transported between the alveoli and blood, between the tissues and blood, all that we discussed in detail. Any doubts, any clarification needed? No. Yes. Yes or no?
No, ma'am.
No. So we'll proceed. Only a few more slides we have to complete, then next day we'll be starting the new chapter. All these chapters are very small chapters. Next we need to learn about the regulation of respiration, how the respiratory mechanism or the respiratory processes are getting regulated. There is a respiratory rhythm center. So we'll be discussing about a few centers or a few areas where the regulation of the respiratory activity takes place. First one, respiratory rhythm center. Respiratory rhythm center, you can see in the picture, the respiratory rhythm center, pneumotaxis center and all you'll be learning. So rhythmicity center, it is mentioned. Same as respiratory rhythm center in violet or violet color it is marked. Location, these are specialized region, it's a specialized region present in the medulla of the brain. You know, medulla oblongata is a part of your hind brain, and it is in this particular organ or in this particular structure, that is medulla oblongata, that the respiratory rhythm center is located, and its function is to regulate respiration. It's a center of respiratory regulation. Then we have pneumotaxis center, green, red color. It is marked as red color, pneumotaxis center. So this is pneumotaxis center. This was respiratory rhythm center or rhythmicity center. And pneumotaxis center, it's located in the pons. Hope you are remembering in class 10, you have learned about pons. Pons is also a part of your hindbrain. And the function, it will moderate. It plays an important role in regulating or moderating the function of respiratory rhythm center. Nerve signals will be sent from this particular area, which will help in reducing the duration of inspiration or inhalation, and accordingly the respiratory center. So two areas, two centers which play an important role in the regulation of respiration we discuss. The first one is respiratory rhythm center. Where is it located? In the medulla. It regulates respiration. And pneumotaxis center, so relate with the letters P and P. Pneumotaxis center is located in the pons, which is a part, medulla as well as pons, both are parts of your hindbrain. Function is to regulate or moderate the function of respiratory rhythm center. In response to the nerve signals sent from pneumotaxis center, the duration of inspiration or inhalation can be adjusted, can be reduced, which will in turn influence the respiratory center. Then we have chemosensitive area. As the name suggests, they are sensitive to chemicals. And you can find it lying adjacent to the rhythm center. It's lying close to the rhythm center. And function, it's highly sensitive to carbon dioxide and hydrogen ion concentration. That is why it got the name chemosensitive area. It is sensitive to these chemical substances, carbon dioxide and hydrogen ion concentration. As their concentration increase, this area will get activated. As and when the carbon dioxide and hydrogen ion concentration is increasing, they will get activated and they provide or they send nerve signals so as to eliminate them or to elimination. How elimination of carbon dioxide is taking place? By exhalation. So once the carbon dioxide and the hydrogen or hydrogen ion concentration increases, this area can sense it and they will send signals so that these products can be removed, or the excess amount of carbon dioxide getting accumulated in your body can be expelled out. Then the fourth one, the fourth area which is associated with the regulation of respiration, aortic arch and carotid artery associated receptors. Carotid artery is associated with your heart. Aortic arch you might be knowing. Aorta, you know. Aorta is the largest artery which is carrying blood from the heart to different parts of the body. It's having an arch on the upper part of this part. This is the aortic arch. This part is the aortic arch. So like this, it comes and from here the branches are formed. So the aortic arch and the carotid artery associated receptors. So some receptors are associated with aortic arch and carotid artery. They play a very important role in regulating respiration. The function of these receptors, they will sense the changes in carbon dioxide and hydrogen ion concentration. Similar to that of chemosensitive area, they also will respond to the changes in carbon dioxide and hydrogen ion concentration, and accordingly they'll be sending signals to the respiratory rhythm center for remedial action so that exhalation can be carried out and these substances can be removed from the body. So similar to that of chemosensitive area, aortic arch and carotid artery associated receptors, some of these receptors which are associated with aortic arch. Aorta is the largest artery in your body, and the carotid artery which is associated with your heart. These receptors, the receptors present over here, they will sense the changes in carbon dioxide as well as hydrogen ion concentration, and when their amount increases, they will send signals to the respiratory rhythm center, which we already discussed, which is present in the medulla oblongata, to take some remedial action. Remedial action means this has to be, these substances should be expelled from our body. So accordingly, they will take, in response to the signals from these centers, respiratory rhythm center will take remedial action. They will exhale these substances out. Now, next we are going to learn about some of the disorders of respiratory system. There are many disorders, but here we need to learn only about a few of them. Starting with first one, asthma. Asthma, the situation. So once you get asthma, the symptoms include difficulty in breathing. There'll be congestion in the respiratory tract or in the lungs. So there'll be difficulty in breathing. Bronchi and bronchioles get inflamed. Okay, it's not. Inflammation of bronchi and bronchioles will take place. There'll be difficulty in breathing, wheezing. I think you are familiar with the term wheezing. So they'll find breathing difficulty, and with that sound, they'll be wheezing. So all these are some of the symptoms of asthma. It's a severe respiratory disorder, and it is a chronic disease. It lasts for a long period of time and affects the person badly because it's a chronic disease. Then emphysema. I think this term you're familiar with because when you go to the theaters or before the movie starts, that advertisement is there, no? To warn you against the different health hazards of smoking. There they are mentioning about emphysema. So it's a chronic disorder. The major cause for emphysema is cigarette smoking. And as a result of prolonged smoking, the alveolar walls, these are the major sites where the exchange of gases is taking place. And these walls will get damaged. So once alveoli, you can see the picture of damaged alveoli and normal alveoli. So once the walls are damaged, the surface area will get decreased for the exchange of gases. Then there'll be breathing difficulty and there can be severe complications, severe health hazards, because it affects your respiratory or as a surface for the exchange of gases is getting reduced, it will cause severe respiratory disorder. There'll be difficulty in breathing. So the major cause is cigarette smoking. And as a result of this prolonged smoking, the alveolar walls can get damaged. Once they are damaged, they get damaged. The surface area available for the exchange of gases get reduced, which will affect the respiratory capacity or the ability to breathe. All that can be affected. And then the last one is about occupational respiratory disorders. So there are certain respiratory disorders which are associated with the job what we are doing, especially when some people are working in factories where too much dust is generated. So the people might inhale, and depending upon, so maybe for some people it may not cause much health impacts, but some will be more susceptible to all these. But generally, prolonged exposure to these substances can result in the damage of your respiratory system. That is why the employees are advised to wear a mask, and all those who are working in such industries or factories, like grinding and stone breaking, it will produce too much amount of dust. And regular exposure of these dust, because on a daily basis they are inhaling these particles. So much dust that the defense mechanism of the body cannot manage. So a small amount of these dust particles are entering, so your body has its own mechanism to expel them out. But on a regular basis, when they are inhaling these particles, the defense mechanism of a body fails to remove them. Long exposure can lead to inflammation of your different parts of your respiratory system and can result in the proliferation of fibrous tissue or fibrosis. So when these people are exposed to these dust particles for a long time, the lungs, for example, the lungs also can get inflamed and can lead to fibrosis, pulmonary fibrosis. So pulmonary fibrosis is a situation where the fibrous tissue rapidly multiplies and the respiratory surface and all get thickened. The normal texture of these respiratory tissues will change. Fibrosis means a rapid multiplication of the fibrous tissue. We call that situation as fibrosis. This will affect the normal functioning ability of the lungs and can cause serious lung damage. So once lungs are damaged, you know what will happen? It will affect the ability of the person to respire properly. And you know how important are lungs, because all the taking in of food cannot give you any energy unless and until the food material, the digested nutrients are broken up with the help of oxygen. For this, oxygen should enter your body, and at the same time, carbon dioxide getting collected in the body should be expelled out. So a great task is performed, a life-sustaining task is performed by our lungs. And when the lungs are damaged, that can lead to severe health hazards. Prevention by wearing some protective mask during work. That also, to certain extent, we cannot say 100% protection we will get by wearing these masks, but to certain extent, wearing a suitable, a proper mask will help these people to avoid exposure to these dust particles. So with that, we have completed the chapter, breathing and exchange of gases. Any doubt? Any topic you found difficult which you want me to repeat again?
Ma'am, that chemosensitive area and aortic.
Okay, I will repeat. So chemosensitive area, as I told you, they'll be sensitive to chemicals, carbon dioxide and hydrogen ion concentration. So when their level is increasing in your body, they will sense it and they will send signals so that these substances can be expelled out from our body. Similar effect is brought about by the receptors which are found associated with aortic arch and the carotid artery. they also will respond to the fluctuations or the increase in carbon dioxide and hydrogen ion concentration. They will also send signals to the respiratory rhythm center indicating that the levels of these substances are rising up, and accordingly they will take remedial action, or they will carry out exhalation, or their increase the rate of exhalation so that these substances are expelled out or removed from our body. I will show those slides once again. Chemosensitive area that is located close to the respiratory rhythm center. They are highly sensitive to these chemicals or carbon dioxide and hydrogen ion concentration. And when their level increases, this area responds to that. This area will respond, chemosensitive area will respond, and they will send signals so that these substances can be eliminated from the body. The other one is receptors which are found associated with the aortic arch and carotid artery, and they also perform the same function. They will respond, or they'll sense the fluctuations in the concentration of carbon dioxide and hydrogen ion, and when their level increases, accordingly they'll be sending signals to the respiratory rhythm center to eliminate them or to take some remedial action.
Ma'am, can you just show the last slide?
Occupational disorders. Shafi?
Yes, ma'am. The last slide, last yes. point I couldn't yes. write.
Those who are working in factories which involve not only grinding and stone breaking, like asbestos factories and all, anywhere, any industry where too much dust is generated, they have to work there. Not for one day or two day, they are getting exposed. On a regular basis, for years, they'll get exposed. So this can result in severe health hazards, because these dust gets accumulated in their respiratory tract or respiratory system. And in the long run, this will result in the damage of their lungs. Lungs or the respiratory organs can get inflamed. They get inflammation takes place and lead to fibrosis. Fibrosis means the fibrous tissue. The fibrous tissue will start multiplying, and it will make the lungs very thick. You know, the wall should be very thin and delicate to facilitate the exchange of gases. So this fibrosis can ultimately cause damage to the lungs, and it will not be efficient in the exchange of gases. And one solution for this is to wear some protective mask during work, which can prevent them from inhaling these dust particles. Okay, Steffi?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Any doubt?
Ma'am, could you explain the regulation of respiration part? I could not hear anything.
Only those four centers you didn't hear?
No, ma'am, I didn't hear anything.
Okay, I'll repeat. There are four areas which are mentioned here. Respiratory rhythm center, pneumotaxis center, then chemosensitive area, and receptors associated with carotid artery and aortic arch. These are the four main areas which are concerned with the regulation of respiration. The first one is respiratory rhythm center. It's located in medulla. Medulla is a part of your hindbrain, and they play a very important role in regulating respiration. The pneumotaxis center, it is located in pons. Pons is also a part of your hindbrain, and its function is to moderate the function of respiratory rhythm center. So this particular area, pneumotaxis center, will send nerve signals which can reduce the duration of inspiration. And when the frequency of inspiration is controlled, accordingly this will influence, this will bring about changes in the respiratory center also. So this is working to control or regulate the functioning of respiratory rhythm center by sending nerve signals. They send nerve signals and they will increase the duration, or increase or decrease, mainly they decrease the duration of inhalation, inspiration, and in that way they will be influencing the respiratory rhythm center. Then the third one is chemosensitive area. They are sensitive to chemical substances like carbon dioxide and hydrogen ion concentration. You know how carbon dioxide and hydrogen ions are being formed. You already learned the transportation of carbon dioxide. So as a result of the catabolic activity, the amount of carbon dioxide can get increased. So this particular area will respond to increased concentration of carbon dioxide and hydrogen ion. And in order to eliminate them, so they'll be getting activated. They send signals, so which will result in the elimination of these substances by increasing the rate of exhalation. And the next one, the receptors associated with aortic arch and carotid artery. Aortic arch is the branches of aorta, that arch is there. So when you had drawn the picture of a heart in 10th standard, you might be remembering that arch, like aorta is the largest artery. There are different branches arising from that. An arch-shaped structure, you can see the aortic arch. So there are some receptors associated with it, as well as with the carotid artery. So the artery which is associated with the heart. Carotid artery is the artery associated with the heart, and they also will respond to changes in carbon dioxide and hydrogen ion concentration, and they'll be sending signals to the respiratory rhythm center so that these substances can be eliminated, can be removed from our body.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, children.